Yeah. Okay, I think I'm a boomer. I think I'm a zoomer. I think I'm a doomer. Damn, I'm a zoomer. Okay. E-double-G-W-H-I-T-E. Coming with the heat.
I stay fooling with my bop. My tunes will make your speakers hot. Dance, floor, hop, scotch, baby, do the pop.
Welcome to the Grillcast, the only podcast in the world dedicated to radical centrism. I am your host, Orion. Joining me, as always, is Micah. What's up, buddy?
Hello.
Hello, Micah. And joining us again is Mason. How are you doing, man?
What's up? Pretty good.
Now, we all are familiar with the political compass. This is a compass which guides smooth brains into thinking that they have some sort of ideology that's cohesive and coherent. Now, people look at the political compass, they think in 2D. They're 2D thinkers. People who ascribe to an ideology that's not radical centrism cannot comprehend 3D or 4D takes. So we've went ahead and we made a new political compass, something that better describes the world as it actually is in a 2D fashion. Mason, why don't you tell us a bit about what you've made?
So I was actually contemplating the base cringe dichotomy. It was an idea I was thinking about where pretty much everything in the world can be divided into base and cringe, but it felt like something was missing. So I added the Chad and Virgin dichotomy. And I think there's some confusion where people correlate these and pretend that these are the same thing. They're really not. And I'm not going to spend a bunch of time explaining the differences between the two because it's intrinsic. And if you know what you're talking about, you understand.
Yeah, you got to explain it. Come on. That's a cringe virgin move right there.
Yeah, actually that's kind of Chad, actually, to just be like, I'm not going to explain this.
I mean, like, what does based mean? You know,
okay, actually that proves your point. If I automatically understood the concept of you not wanting to explain it to be Chad behavior, then I actually do understand, so I don't need an explanation.
Yeah, I don't know if we have other words that quite capture the essence of these terms correctly.
You know, I think the best way that we can explain this new dichotomy to our viewers is with some examples, some familiar faces that highlight, you know, what exactly it means to be based, to be a Chad, to be cringe, to be a virgin. Now, it's virgin to Chad on the x-axis, cringe and based on the y-axis. And we're going to go ahead and chart some major political figures that you may love or hate. We'll start off with Jeb Bush. Now, what do you guys think about Jeb Bush? Where do you think he falls?
I like Jeb Bush as a starting place because I think Jeb Bush is the perfect example of a rare class, the based virgin, okay? He's definitely a virgin, right? This is Jeb Bush. I mean, come on. But he does funny shit sometimes, and everybody loves him. And he's a member of the Bush family, which kind of just automatically makes him base because they just dominate the shit out of everyone, you know?
He does have a wife, which makes you wonder, how could he be a virgin? He has a wife, he has a child, but his wife is ugly, and it doesn't count if she's ugly. This we all know to be true.
Okay, yeah. So you're a virgin, but you're also part of the political, like, the high end of the power hierarchy.
Yeah.
I mean,
you know, he's not a Chad at all. We all know this, but he's definitely not cringe. Like, I don't know. He's kind of endearing. Like when I watch him, when I even through his blusters and failures, I'm like, aw, what a nice little guy, you know?
He's memeable. Everybody's rooting for Jeb, you know?
You can't help but like look at him and his like his slumpy posture and it's just like out of breath. You know, I can't be like upset with him. You know, I root for him. Absolutely.
Do you guys remember when he whipped out the turtles?
Yeah, I was about to say that, bro.
He's like, these are my little turtles. Like, dude, he's based in a profound way. Like, he's like found his center, you know? I don't know. He doesn't need the lust for war or whatever the hell drives the rest of the Bushes.
We can all agree that autism in his particular form of it is based.
Yeah.
And that's why Jeb Bush goes squarely on the top of the virgin and based quadrant. Now, our next guy that we're going to throw up on here is Joe Manchin.
Okay, well, I think it goes without saying that Joe Manchin is a based Chad. I'm not going to say where exactly in the quadrant he deserves to go, high, low, whatever, but he has to go in that quadrant.
So I have literally no idea who this person is, but Manchin is his last name.
Literally. Manchin.
Who is this?
That's a base Chad last name.
All you really need to know is that he is a 6'3" centrist senator who basically holds the Democratic Party by the balls right now. And he can do whatever he wants, okay? He can do whatever he wants. He's a physical Chad and also an ideological Chad as far as we're concerned. So no matter what, just make sure he is in the correct quadrant.
Didn't you say that he's in the, he promised an endless filibuster?
He recently shut down the Democrats' hopes of ending the filibuster. He basically said, no, actually, I'm going to allow the Republicans to filibuster whenever and however they want, because, you know, I think that should that tradition of wasting everybody's time should continue to exist.
Whoa, that's the best opinion I've actually ever heard. See, everyone hates political gridlock, but I actively think that both parties are pursuing ends that are worse for my life. And so political gridlock, top tier good.
He's like a statue standing in the way of anybody who wants to do anything. Immovable, just made of concrete and titanium.
But rock also, hard. At the same time, when Republicans come to him trying to get him to come over, he'll be like, no, I'm not going to do that.
So did he filibuster for the Democrats in the last?
What he did was he guaranteed that Democrats would not have the votes to end the filibuster.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
that's pretty high tier. I mean, that's very Chad and based. I mean,
also,
dude, that's
he's
crazy.
He's a 6'3" high profile figure. Yeah, we've covered all the ground. You know,
where do we put this?
Like most powerful guy from West Virginia. You know,
he is the most powerful senator in the entire country.
Exactly.
Let's not discount that. And for that, I think he goes all the way up on Chad. And let's say 3/4 over on based.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to spoil our top Chad slot, though. Like, God, that is unbelievably Chad, but I am concerned about...
Oh, there's room. There is room. Now, Alex Jones is going to be our next candidate here. And Alex Jones, I would argue, goes firmly into the Chad cringe. This man is an absolute unit and powerhouse. His energy is boundless. You know, he's somebody that I can't even comprehend how you have that much iron will in you, that much.
Dude, just one man that takes on the globalists, like
a man against an entire globe. But, you know, no, you might think, well, that's pretty based. Why would you put him in the cringe? And it's because he frequently melts down. He frequently, you know, like on Joe Rogan, he drank himself into a coma and then made himself look like a total retard. Like, he frequently does really cringy things. And I actually have a new video of Alex Jones. And in this video, he purports to stop human trafficking. You guys want to watch that with me?
Sure.
Yeah, let's see.
Hit it.
All right. So here he goes.
You got a car seat for them?
Oh.
You got a car seat? That's illegal, bro.
Where are you taking these kids?
That's illegal.
If you get in a traffic accident, those kids are going to get hurt.
You have a car seat.
That's illegal.
How is this Christian?
Hey, we need the police over here. They got a bunch of kids without their car seats. You're violating Texas law.
Who is this right here?
Hey,
you have no comment. So
you
this
got those
is private.
Kids here illegally.
See, that's pretty cringe. She's trying to enforce car seatbelt laws.
Traffic laws, yeah.
That's pretty unbearably cringe.
It's already cringe when police officers enforce traffic laws, but like if you're just a citizen and doing it, like God forbid you're on camera.
Oh, man. I hate it because I love Alex Jones, but that's like some YouTuber shit, man. That's like some bad YouTuber shit. I mean...
Now, you might think that, you know, that just firmly places him as cringe. How is he a Chad at all? This next video is going to show just exactly how he's a Chad.
About to run a human being
Look
over.
At him push this car.
Who are you? You got those little children illegally.
Who are you?
Look at him with
Where
this fat
this
gut hanging
children?
Out.
Are you a part
you
of
got to be legally in that vehicle.
You're not a part of this organization? Who are you? Where are you
we
taking
know you're
these kids?
These
I feel like
Where are you taking these kids?
The
I feel like this was staged.
Where are you taking these kids? Sir, identify
This is
who
a massive
are.
Smuggling.
I don't think so.
This is literally human
Dude,
smuggling. These are
I keep
children.
Waiting for him to flip
where
over
are you
the car.
These kids?
And now
Sir, where are you taking
the
these kids?
They don't even have
Look
car
at the
seats.
Woman in there.
Their seatbelts aren't even on.
You see the kids sticking
his children?
Dude, that woman's like, why the fuck did I leave Guatemala? Why am I here?
People don't understand that, like, how chaotic the United States is. Like, this, how chaotic our people are. They don't understand it, and then they get here. And then fucking Alex Jones accosts you in the middle of the street, and you're like, oh, okay, this is America.
I just want to say, though, how Chad of a move it was for him to be just, like, pushing up against that car, screaming, you're not going anywhere. You're stuck here with me.
Like I said, I was waiting for him to just grab that car and flip it over, regardless of the children. Like,
they're not wearing seatbelts. Flip.
Dude, I mean, do you guys remember when he drove his, like, armored car into a protest and then was, like, yelling shit from the pulpit?
No.
Are you unaware? Okay, so Alex Jones owns, like, an armored car, right? Basically a tank that you can drive on the street. And then, I don't know, he's driving through some, like, crowd. I think it was one of the big protest videos that were, like, clashing protesters. And people are just, like, throwing shit at his car and spray painting it. And then he's, like, yelling shit through the microphone mounted on his armored car about, like, the New World Order and the globalists and shit.
Oh, is that, like, really old?
No, it's like a year ago. I mean, that feels really old. It was pre-corona.
Well, anyway, he detains them and waits for the cops to arrive. And this is what happens.
These people are being human trafficked and raped. They're being raped. They're being raped. They're being human trafficked.
Just let them do their job.
How do you know? How do you know?
How do I know? It's happening on a daily basis at the southern border.
You doing that? How do you know?
Go to the southern border.
That's the mom.
Mother, yo.
Yeah, all sorts of fucked up.
With three of my kids in the back of the car, I can do it.
Take me home, Guatemala Road.
That is unimaginably cringe. Oh my God.
Yeah, I don't know why Alex Jones would do that. I personally would trust the Catholic Community Service with kids.
Dude, but I mean, they have people driving around doing things with like Catholic churches and shit like that. It's not that far-fetched for some kids to be in the back. Just a poor worker who's just like, whatever, they don't need to like all wear seat belts. Oh man, dude. That's so cringe. Shit hurts.
It is very cringe. And I think that justifies Alex Jones being put firmly in the
I wouldn't put him as top two, Chad. I don't know. I feel like he's very Chad, but if we're talking about political figures, there's people who like ball on nations, you know? I feel like we can't put him as top tier Chad.
Yeah.
I don't think he's max cringe either.
Yeah, maybe right here.
Yeah.
About two quarters down on cringe, two quarters to the side on Chad.
Yeah, that particular episode, top tier cringe, but Alex Jones has a long career, and some of his stuff has been not, you know, pretty base. I'll give him a little bit of doubt.
Yeah,
like,
true.
But I'll put him in cringe overall, definitely, because he's done a lot of cringe shit.
Now, if we want to talk about a cringe lord, we should talk about Ben Shapiro, the next guy on our list.
Mr. My wife's a doctor.
Yeah. Ben Shapiro, firmly the very most virgin and cringe that you can get.
Yeah.
Absolute bottom.
I don't really feel like we need to talk too much about this. If you don't agree with this, you're just wrong. He's top tier virgin cringe.
Yeah. Oh, I think we do need to talk a little about this. Ben Shapiro is the whiniest manlit dweeb in existence. Every time I hear his voice, it's so grating on my goddamn ears, like nails on a chalkboard. To hear him talk, I
talk faster than you, so I win.
It's like if Destiny had no personality and never owned anyone. It's horrible. It's awful.
It's worse, and it's worse than Destiny's like speed amphetamine talking because it's all nasally. There's nothing there other than just like nasally condescension, and then like I just don't understand how he does what he does, and
had one of his like things where he went to a college campus and talked shit to people, and some dude just grabbed him and hauled him into the bathroom and gave him a swirly on stream.
Yeah, like just pick him up from the podium.
That should have happened. That's something.
That is a guy who gets swirled.
It's why the practice exists, you know? Like, he's an example of why bullying and swirlies and things like that were a part of our culture, you know, and why they're needed.
It's an essential service that bullies provide.
He's the guy that raises his hand and answers every question in the classroom.
Like, and every time you hear his voice, it's just like, man, shut up.
God, Jesus Christ.
He's a kid that's like, teacher, we didn't turn in our homework.
we forgot to turn it on.
And then you didn't do homework and you thought you were going to get away with it scot-free. Now, yeah. I'd like to just shortly discuss his cringiest tweet. When he's talking about wet-ass pussy and he tweets out, "Listen, guys, I fully explained on the show that it's misogynistic to question whether wet graphic descriptions of wet-ass pussy is empowering for women. WAP is obviously an incredibly profound statement of women's empowerment, a la Susan B. Anthony." That is some biting fucking satire,
dude,
Ben Shapiro.
Damn, dude. He got him.
Yeah, you fucking...
He got
you him. You owned them. Feminoids BTFO. As I also discussed on the show, my only real concern is that the women involved, who apparently require a bucket and a mop, get the medical care they require. My doctor wife's differential diagnosis, bacterial vaginosis, yeast infection, or trichomonas. This is a guy that is like, honey, women's vaginas get wet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
He learned all those words from his wife talking to him about what vaginas are like.
Yeah. Yes, Benny boy. Vaginas don't get wet. That's why I'm always dry as the Sahara. I love you for you and not for your money. Yeah, it's just such a cringe moment.
What is a metaphor?
Telling everybody on the goddamn planet that his wife doesn't get wet to own the feminoids.
I don't believe they had kids by any other means other than in vitro fertilization. Like, I just don't, I don't believe that anything else
happened.
Yeah,
I don't think Ben Shapiro can get a boner. Nothing I've seen from him leads me to believe he's capable of that.
I do want to say, too, that WAP is a banger, and Cardi B honestly is the best female rap artist in a long time.
So.
Okay, noted.
Noted. So Ben Shapiro goes firmly. Bam. You know what? Can I get that farther over? It should be popping out of the fucking screen. Just popping out.
Extend the
quadrant. He's carving a hole in the corner and burrowing in. Now, often the target of Ben Shapiro's ire is AOC. What do you guys think about AOC?
AOC is kind of dope. She stirs a lot of salt, you know? She knows how to touch the right buttons.
You know, that's my general thought on her, too. She complains a lot. She's kind of like whiny and naggy. But she does it in a way that pisses a lot of people off and encourages people that are like her to feel empowered. She's a really good manipulator. Here's my thoughts on AOC is that it was either this or OnlyFans.
Well, that's the thing, though. That's the thing. A lot of people want her sexually and, like, idolize her sexually so that, you know, being highly sexually desirable is pretty Chad, okay?
Definitely.
And then she throws like lots of shade all over the place, this way, that way, left and right. I mean, she is an extremist herself, you could say, you know, to some people. But she has, you know, she has reasonable beliefs and things that I support, things that I like. And I like the fact that she you know, takes shit. You know, she takes a shit on a lot of these people, her colleagues, and, you know, they have to walk into each other at work and, you know, awkwardly talk about really, you know, boring shit after she, you know, burns them on social media.
I feel like more rightoids are sexually attracted to AOC than leftoids.
Yeah, it's like a repressed thing.
Well, that's because leftoids have more things to be sexually attracted to.
Yeah, they have a bigger pool.
It's an uneven distribution.
So here's a pretty good example of an AOC brand. She's talking to Ted Cruz on Twitter. They often go back and forth, and Ted Cruz always gets blown the fuck out, like every time. You know, he's talking about AOC explains the real Dem position. Abolish ICE, full open borders. You know, just shit like that.
Hashtag Biden border crisis.
And so,
dude, they're doing that. It's funny.
AOC says, Ted, this is pretty rich coming from someone who fled their own home and responsibilities during an environmental crisis to cross the border and seek refuge in Mexico. Also, you funded cages, expanded cages, and yet you're complaining about cages. You have no policy, just puff. Maybe Mexico shouldn't let you in next time you try to run away from your job to sip umbrella drinks in Cancun. That's a pretty sicko line.
Oh, man, yeah. That's a great line. Jesus.
I like the comparison, too, that, like, Mexicans are coming up here to sip umbrella drinks. They're comparable.
I mean, it is kind of funny how, like, I don't know, a bunch of right-wingers are going after the immigration thing right now. They're like, look, it's... Because it actually has gotten worse because Trump's out of office, so a lot of Mexicans are like, now that Trump's out of office, we can cross the border, you know? I mean, it's pretty compelling logic, honestly. So it has gotten a little worse, and, like, a bunch of right-wingers are talking about it.
And they pretend, I don't know, man, they pretend like they give a shit about, oh, kids are still in cages. It's like, yeah, no one actually cares about that on either side.
Wait, literally nobody.
Did you guys see the AOC Ted Cruz tweet where, so AOC tweeted something, and I can't even remember what it was, but Ted Cruz agreed with her. Oh, it was about GameStop, honestly. Actually,
yeah,
and
it was
so
about the
Ted
stock
Cruz
market,
agreed
so.
With her, and then she clapped back at Ted Cruz like, you supported insurrectionists who tried to murder me on January 6th.
Yeah, that was pretty cringe.
I don't want your support. Yeah. Oh man,
her whole thing with that, and then she went on like TikTok or what the fuck ever she streams on.
Yeah,
we covered that. She's crying and like, they tried to kill me. It's like, oh my, get the fuck over yourself.
On the
that was kind of cringe.
Was the when she took the photos at the camp full of children in cages, that was pretty cringe where she's like crying.
but hold on, let's also look at what other points of contention do we have. Well, if you look at like the person she's dating, she's definitely the dominant person in that relationship.
Oh, big time.
Yeah, I mean, that
she makes more money, she has a bigger dick.
That guy's absolutely.
So I think it would be pretty fair.
Maybe the lower end of base and Chad.
Yeah,
more Chad than based, but
yeah,
still
yeah.
Base.
More Chad than based,
but still
so
base.
Maybe
but
like
definitely.
A third onto Chad and just barely based.
Yeah, I would say that's pretty acceptable.
All right. We talked about Ted Cruz getting smacked around a little bit, and for our next one, we're going to do Ted Cruz when he doesn't have a beard. I think we can all agree that he's a cringe virgin. He's just always whiny. He got cucked by Donald Trump.
That's really the big one. It's just how we watched him get torn apart by Donald Trump in the 2016 election. You know, like, Trump was saying that his dad killed JFK. He, like, said some shit about his wife or whatever.
He called his wife
Dude.
Ugly. Yeah.
Yeah, he called his wife ugly. Yeah. Refused to apologize. And then fucking Ted Cruz just stepped in line when Trump won.
His whole like, life and political career, to me, feels like scripted, but it's not being played well. Like, it's someone who's reading off a script and not playing the part well. Like, they're failing to play the part. I don't know how to describe it.
He just
comes off in a weird
way.
Yeah,
people always talked about him being like a robot or a psychopath was the big one, you know, a serial killer.
He's so cringe and such a virgin that he beat Beto O'Rourke by like 2 points, who was talking about literally taking everyone's guns.
Yeah,
openly.
In Texas.
In Texas.
Is he more virgin than cringe, or more cringe than virgin? Is, I guess, the question we're really contemplating.
I think he's like full cringe.
Yeah.
I think he's full.
But not quite full virgin.
He's definitely cringe. Yeah.
Yeah, full cringe. And then on virgin, maybe like 2/3 over.
Yeah.
Maybe halfway.
Yeah, that's acceptable. I mean, is he he's not as cringe as Ben Shapiro, though.
Yeah. No. Okay. Yeah, we'll move him up a little bit.
Yeah.
We're reasonable people.
Yeah, I mean,
to say he's as cringe as Ben Shapiro is, I mean, that's slander. I think we could get sued for that.
Yeah, that's not true.
So maybe like 2/3 down cringe, and like halfway virgin. And so we'll move on to Ted Cruz with a beard. I think the beard totally transforms him, honestly.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think he's you know, basically the exact opposite side of the cringed and based axis.
Yeah.
But probably still a virgin.
I don't know. The thing about it is he's still getting shit on by AOC, like we just looked at, which is pretty cringe.
But he's got a beard.
He definitely looks a lot better. And honestly, his whole like attacking AOC, like while her clapback was way better, you know, like his like straight right to open the Twitter bout wasn't bad. Like, hey, AOC, you don't care about immigrants. That's pretty funny.
Yeah, but everybody knows that.
It was a Chad move, but it was cringe because he did it so badly.
Yeah, the clapback was too strong.
Yeah, he just couldn't handle it. I think it'd be safe because he is a totally transformed person. I think he just flips the y-axis.
Yeah, not totally, though. No, I feel like he's slightly on the Chad side. He's not...
No, he's not like a full-blown Chad.
Yeah, definitely not. But he looks pretty Chad now.
By no means is he a full Chad. But you know who is a full Chad?
Oh,
full
yeah.
Chad, full oh, yeah. based. The only man who could take the title of the most based Chad king on the planet, John McAfee. Yes.
Yeah. What's going on with him right now? He's in jail, right?
He is in jail for tax evasion.
And
he
murder.
Sailed...
And rape?
No, he got away production. With that.
Oh, he never
he said he got away with it.
He got away
you
with
it. You mean he didn't do it? You mean he did not do it?
Wait. I want
Those are the same thing.
I want to clarify right now. John McAfee never raped anyone. He murdered a guy, but the guy killed his dog.
That's fair.
Yeah.
So John McAfee's story is that he announced his Libertarian Party candidacy, and he didn't do it from America. He's been sailing in international waters on a yacht and telling the IRS, I'm never paying my taxes, fuck you, it's my money. That is such a base Chad move. And, you know, it's sad that it caught up with him. He's currently in jail, and he directs his wife to do his posts on Facebook for him. So he still talks to people. There was a point where we probably could have had him call into the podcast. He would talk to fucking anyone. He talked to Crippled Jesus, who we had on a few episodes.
Holy
ago.
Shit, really?
Yeah, this was a guy, he went on like every show. He was a real cool guy.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't even mentioned the whole like drug compound or like, you know, the murder itself too much. There's a lot to his life that is incredibly based and incredibly Chad.
A self-made millionaire, early Bitcoin adopter, still right
okay,
now.
Okay, to be fair, this is the only man that could run on the Libertarian ticket and not be cringe.
Yeah,
exactly.
That has to be clear. Exactly. Like that, Libertarians need to just get it together and actually support John McAfee. Like, get together a national libertarian fund to pay for John McAfee's bail or something. I don't know why you need to pay for a billionaire's bail.
Dude,
just go
yeah,
with
they,
it.
I don't know how much his bail is set at, but I think that they bring in like $1 million annually as a party. That's it.
He needs to run in a serious fashion with real support. He'd be the best president we'd ever have.
Absolutely.
And that's why he goes firmly into the based Chad category. You know, while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to see if I can call him in jail. See if I can set that up.
That'd be sick.
So we're gonna flip axes here real quick and talk about Bernie Sanders. Mm. Now, I'll let one of you give an argument to where he goes.
I would put him pretty close to the center. I would put Bernie somewhere in the center because he has done, at least in my lifetime, he has done things that would categorize him, you know, any which way. So I can't like firmly put him in one quadrant or the other specifically. I don't know if Mason has a differing opinion, but
so there's a lot of variables to consider with Bernie Sanders because he's kind of base. Like he's like fights for workers' rights. One time he talked about how great Castro was. That's pretty base. And he's kind of a Chad just for straight up being like, yeah, I'm a socialist and actually getting a seat.
I don't give a shit.
Like ready for president. That's pretty Chad. But he also has things like one of the big ones is when he was, well, the biggest one, obviously, is running twice, getting absolutely wrecked by his own party. And then they just like acknowledge it or like, yeah, we fucked you over, do something. And he doesn't do shit and just like continues.
Takes it.
Like,
yeah, he just takes it.
And I get his like, I need to do rational change, but that's definitely some like cuck shit. Like, I gotta work within the system.
But that's just that's telling because it shows you just that's the kind of guy he is. Like he'll roll over when you know push comes to shove. Just like when those two black women walked up on stage and took the microphone out of his hands, he just let it happen. I mean, bro,
he just stood back and he did that thing that he does, like you know when he puts his head down and like looks at the floor.
Yeah, like
he does the virgin stare.
Yeah. And like, dude, you own four houses. You don't have to put up with this, okay? You're a land, you're honorary land Chad. Like, you know, even if you don't rent out the homes, you know, you could if you wanted to. You don't have to put up with this rentoid behavior.
I am not a billionaire. I am
trillionaire.
For the people.
No, I actually do think that Bernie Sanders is pretty like ideologically pure. Like I think he's a little harder line of a socialist than he says he is, but I think
fucking Vaush is ideologically pure, you know. So what is being ideologically pure have to do with this metric?
Vaush is fat and Bernie Sanders isn't, so
Bernie Sanders is a United States senator who ran for president. Vaush is some douchebag on the internet. So like
impossible pedophile.
Yeah.
This woman looks like the ogre from Shrek.
Having some pretty like radical views and getting as far as he does is pretty impressive, you know. Yeah, he got
I would put him right in the middle. I would put him in the middle but on the base side. Like a little bit above. I don't know.
I would put him like into based maybe a quarter but then into virgin a quarter because he does get cucked like a lot. There needs to be some recognition of that.
I think that's valid. I think that's
extremely fair.
Cuz I think his commitment is pretty base, but I think the way he got cucked by the DNC, which to be fair, you know, most people would get cucked by the DNC. crazy, but, you know, yeah.
Well, speaking of people who cuck people using the DNC, our next candidate is Hillary Clinton. I think Hillary Clinton, another corner spot we're filling out here, goes firmly all the way to Chad and all the way to cringe.
Mm-hmm.
And here's my argument for this. I mean, we all remember the hot sauce moment, Pokemon Go to the pool. I mean, and just listening to her talk, like every time she would open her mouth, I'd be like, you're so shrill and bossy. Oh my God. But, you know, at the same time, she probably murders people. She definitely did when she was Secretary of State. Just like, I don't know. She's cold, calculating. I would not fuck with her in any way. If she's listening to this somehow, I'm so sorry. Those were all jokes. I actually voted for you or something.
Unironically.
Whatever it'll take. I'm sorry.
The thing about Hillary is, yeah, she's an undisputed top tier Chad, because like the one that really hammered it home for me was watching like stuff from the Snowden documentaries around it. Glenn Greenwald talked a bunch about Hillary Clinton, and just the fear from, like, I don't know. She's like a super villain, you know. She controlled the
milking the nation of Haiti for construction contracts.
Yeah, yeah.
Extremely Chad.
Or like the way she dresses. The way she dresses in, like, the evil woman pantsuit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The dictator attire.
Promise, she's such a, like, shady, like, from the shadows ruler, which she's very, like, efficient at, but she never got her public face quite correct, you know? She wasn't ready for the big limelight. She wasn't ready to be televised. She's more of a, I don't know.
The man behind the curtain.
I feel like that's why Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton are at, you know, polar opposites. It's because Jeb Bush is endearing. He's just a turbo virgin. Whereas, you know, Hillary Clinton, total Chad killer, but she's just so off-putting that it's like, you know, they end up in similar situations getting cucked by Donald Trump.
Can you imagine if Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton had been the election instead of Trump? If Trump just hadn't come in, life would be like a different sort of comedy. You know what I mean?
I think it would be, I don't know. I think it would be boring. Even now with Joe Biden as president, I think for whatever reason, like, politics has just become more entertaining.
So we all agree that Hillary Clinton is firmly in the Chad cringe corner.
Yeah,
that's fair.
All right. So speaking of Joe Biden is an anomaly. He's definitely a based Chad, but he's cringe in that he sniffs children, and having dementia is kind of cringe.
I heavily disagree on that. Dementia itself isn't really cringe, and becoming the president of the United States while you have dementia is super based. And Chad.
One or the other.
I think it's both a based and a Chad move.
I think it's pretty undeniable that Joe Biden is a based Chad.
Yeah.
What really solidifies this for me is, do you remember that video where, like, that fucking factory worker, that dumb blue-collar idiot, was arguing with Joe Biden about his gun legislation, and Joe Biden was like, I'll slap you. Do you want to take this outside?
It challenges people to push-up
contest. Yeah, that was the city hall where he called the guy fat. He's like, he called this guy fat.
That was
challenged the guy. So the guy had questions about his mental infirmness when he had dementia, and Joe Biden's like, calls him a fat fuck and challenges him to a push-up contest.
I loved it. I loved it, especially when he told that, like, the guy asking about guns, like, I'm not your boss, Jack, and everybody was on, like, all these conservatives were crying, like, oh, but look at what he's saying. These people are supposed to be our represent. They work for us. And it's like, no, retard, they don't fucking work for you just because you voted for them. You idiot.
Remember what Joe Biden said, that if he was still in high, if Donald Trump was at his high school, he would have beaten him up.
Yeah.
I've seen pictures of both of them at that age, and I completely believe that.
I don't know. Trump is tall as shit. I didn't know this. I thought he was kind of short and pudgy. He's actually like 6'3 or some shit.
Yeah, no, he's tall. But
he also got expelled from his school and sent to boarding school because he kept beating people up.
Joe Biden? Way.
No, Trump.
Oh, is that true? Okay.
He was a bully. we'll talk about him in a second. As far as where Joe Biden goes, you know, I would say probably like three quarters quarters Chad and like one third base. Does that sound?
Yeah, that sounds pretty valid to me. I don't know.
He's more Chad. Chad.
Yeah, he's more Chad than based. He's based in the way that like most old people are, or he calls things malarkey.
Ain't nothing gonna change.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Right. We love Joe Biden. Let me be clear, okay? Here on this show, Joe Biden is approved of always.
Now, not only do we love Joe Biden, but we love Donald Trump, yes, with the qualifier of 2016 primary Donald, yes, Trump.
Yeah.
I would put him, we put Joe Biden more Chad than based. I would put Donald Trump in this category more based than Chad.
I disagree too.
Because, disagree?
Dude, he's so high tier in 2016. There's some real differences here. 2016 primary, Republican primary, particularly we're talking about. Yeah. That's when he shifted into beast mode and propelled himself from a pool of like 9 candidates to the top by just shitting on everyone.
Yeah.
Which had
and
never
then just
been done.
stood atop of the corpses. Yeah, of corpses. Continuing to like beat these dead bodies, the proverbial dead horses that all the rest of the candidates were.
Like we mentioned earlier, when Trump said that Ted Cruz's dad killed JFK, that was after Ted Cruz was out. That was like the day that he announced that he was gone, and Trump's just on his way out.
He called his wife ugly before that.
Oh, no. Yeah. I thought that. Wait. He said that about Ted Cruz? I thought that was Jeb Bush's dad.
No, he said that Ted Cruz's dad killed JFK. He said a lot of other shit. I'm pretty sure he even insinuated that Bush did 9/11.
Yeah,
he was
did.
All over, and he just, like, stomped. Even, like, the actual, you know, him against Hillary, he wasn't even in top form for that. Those debates were actually kind of forgettable, but the primary, dude, like, he was shredded. He was a king.
They were the best debates of all time.
Yeah, like low energy Jeb. Like
there will never be YouTube compilations of debates of that quality ever again.
Rand Paul, he called him a midget. He just went off. Like,
yeah, he just went one through one, like fucking Kill Bill.
Just like I don't need your money to AIPAC. Did you guys see that where like the people where he went and talked to AIPAC, they booed him and he was like, that's fine, I don't need your money.
Yeah, so I don't think he's as base. We can't really put his base as John McAfee because like it's just not, and also because we're talking about a flash in the pan here.
Yeah, you know? that's one thing is it wasn't lifelong. It was a fun summer,
but we're talking we're
one of those summers
about. But that you have to remember, this is the context though, is Trump 2016.
This is true. I would say probably that you've swayed me. I would say all the way at Chad and then like two-thirds the way up based.
Yeah, well, yeah. But I think he's more Chad than based. Like, he's not crazy based with his views. I mean, some of them were pretty funny, like build a wall. But he was definitely Chad in how he just cut down the competition mercilessly.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, we're going to move on to Donald Trump in 2021. This is a 5-year passage of time that completely changed the man. Now, this is somebody who went from being the based Chad we all knew and loved, somebody so strong, striking down his opponents mercilessly one by one, and he's been reduced and withered to nothing. Years of policy failures, years of being harped on by the media, being banned off Twitter, being banned off all social media, and doing nothing about it. And now he just kind of like sits in the background and like puts out a press statement every once in a while that they're a little funny, but like, you know, not really.
Yeah. No one cares. Yeah, I mean, cutting off Twitter was huge, which they did immediately when they got a Senate majority, or the Democrats got a Senate majority. But he's just gone. And you got to consider, too, when you say 2021, obviously the January 6th like, thing, the fucking riot.
Yeah.
Like, right there. And since that, he's just been non-existent. That was the last he interacted with public life in a meaningful way, I feel like. I mean, there might have been other shit, but I sure haven't heard about it. I think he's issued some statements, but
yeah, he has.
He pretty much
just sold his supporters down the road when he did that too. When that thing happened, he's like, oh, I had nothing to do with that. Please leave me alone. I'm sorry. And then just went and hid. And he's still in hiding, like Bin Laden in cave.
Yeah.
After 9/11. Like
he did insinuate he was gonna run again.
He has talked about running again, but that's not going to happen. He's so old.
Which is kind of base.
What do you mean? Yeah. See, he'll be Biden's age by the time the next election rolls around.
I thought they were pretty much the same.
No, he's 4 years younger than Biden.
Wow. Okay. Number one. All right.
Yeah, he's 74, Biden's 78.
I don't think that'll happen, though.
I mean, he says it will, but I think he's just trying to get more money. Maybe he will, though. Leaving that open-ended. You know, I feel like as a former president, you're automatically in the Chad Club.
It would be cool to see a Donald Trump resurrection arc. You know what I mean?
Like, it would be, but I think for now, he's in the Chad cringe.
Yeah. Even the Chad is hard to say. Like, I mean, he's a former president, but he kind of got like wrecked out of everything. Like, we're talking about particularly 2021. Like, we're talking about just the
look,
primaries.
He's still a billionaire who just trash talks people. But, you know, now it's just slightly cringe. But the behavior is Chad-like.
But we're in the context of this list, too. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, man. He's pretty, yeah.
I'd say probably halfway down cringe and then like maybe in the middle of Chad.
Less than in the middle of Chad. He's not that Chad. I don't think he's been as Chad as AOC has been this year.
Okay, yeah, you know what? I'm swayed by your argument. I would put him, we don't know where he's at right now. He's in limbo. I would say we put him in cringe and then perfectly on the axis of Virgin and Chad.
I think we do.
See, this is centrism, boys. Figuring out the problems that matter. You can only get this here on the Grillcast.
If only we could get people to vote based on these ratings. Although, base Chad doesn't necessarily mean they're a good person.
No, yeah, absolutely no. Not.
Jesus Christ.
That's not what that means at all.
Whatever you do, don't look at this graph and vote.
So, our next guy is going to be Karl Marx. I'll let Mason make the case for this one.
Hey, Karl Marx, huge virgin. He might have been a literal virgin. I'm not totally sure. He was just kind of like, I know he was basically like a recluse. He didn't do, other than writing a lot of shit, he didn't do that much. He's a virgin. But communism's pretty based, especially like his kill tally is huge.
He is responsible for so much death.
And, I mean, you know, just a lot of cultural formation and untold number of wars, like, beyond just death itself. Communism's, like, shaped the planet. It's the big other ideology. And just writing some shit on paper and doing that much damage is pretty based.
Wasn't he basically a neat? Like, he didn't do anything?
Yeah. He was basically a neat that wrote the, like, biggest shitpost ever written. that totally fucked the world up.
That's pretty like, base.
I do feel like, in a way, like, everyone who's ever come up with, like, a political theory or philosophy thinks, like, it's themselves versus anarcho-primitivism.
Yeah.
And they're like explaining like, look, without my thing that I just came up with, this is what you get, basically.
There can't be society that, unless it's my society.
To be fair though, communism is kind of based in some ways in like fully automated communism where all needs are already met through technology. That's pretty based. I'm down with that.
I'm not even that dude.
I hate futurism nerds. I hate them. They're so fucking annoying.
I hate futurism.
Elon Musk is so cool. Look at the Starlink, dude. Look at the Tesla, dude. The future is going to be so cool. We're going to be like Star Trek, except we're all going to be gay.
Like, nah, bro.
Fuck off.
No. I'm going to like turn myself into like, I'm just going to have my brain wired into like a starship and fly around and go in VR at will.
Dude, it'll be so cool. The government's just going to give me a VR and I'm going to connect to porn all day. And then my feed tube is going to inject soy directly into my bloodstream. I'll never have to do anything again.
Okay, you better stop making promises, okay? Or I'm going to vote for you.
So anyway, what's your problem with that? At least they'd be doing something useful. All they do now is bomb people and fucking lose money.
My problem with that is I was using a soy voice to denote that it was cringe. But I don't know if I really have an argument.
Okay, I mean, that's fair. That's valid. That's a valid...
What's cringe is being a wagey. Yeah.
Well, anyway, I think as far as where we put Karl Marx, obviously he is in the based quadrant and in the virgin quadrant.
Yeah.
Maybe two-thirds the way up.
Maybe a little further.
A little further to the virgin or based?
Didn't he, like, live with his mother until he was in his, like, dead?
Until he was in his, like, grave.
That's all the way virgin. All the way virgin and halfway up based. What do you think?
I think he's more based than that. Yeah. I also don't think he's as virgin as Jeb Bush or
really
Shapiro, even though he's a literal virgin and they are.
Hey, dude, you think Jeb Bush is such a virgin that you think he's gender neutral? You don't even see him as a man. That's why he's so far in the corner right there. That was like subconscious shit right there. Yeah, he can't be that much of a virgin. I'll put him a little under Jeb Bush on both sides. That was a strong argument. And let's see how much time we got left.
Plus, he haunts the dreams of like college girl revolutionaries. Karl Marx isn't even a real virgin.
I guess for 15, we'll go to Elizabeth Warren. What do you guys think? Definitely in the cringe quadrant. Cringe.
Dude, I'll never forget the Pocahontas, man. I mean, like, why did she do that? You know what I mean? Why she released her own test results?
The fact that she still avoids the subject and just wouldn't address it, like, in a correct way. In the correct way, which would be to say, no, I'm white. Oops, my bad.
No, yeah. the correct way is just to never address it at all. I don't know.
Right, never. But after the fact, I mean, what she should have done is just been like, that was stupid of me, you know. But instead, she just avoids the subject, acts like, doesn't confirm or deny it anymore, affirm or deny it.
Well, she released her own DNA results on Twitter that showed she was like 1/64th Indian. And that was what happened. Yeah, like in response to the Pocahontas thing, she released her own on Twitter and then was like, see, I am native.
No, idiot.
Yeah, that was a cringe-o move for sure. And then that, I don't know if you ever saw that video when she's running for president and she cracks open a beer and she drinks it. And, you know, she's trying to do the AOC style, like, I'm just talking into the camera and streaming or some shit. And she tries so hard to appear casual, like, yes, I drink beer too. I'm also a person. And it's so unconvincing and she looks so old and haggard.
Because she is old and haggard.
But then, I don't know, she's a little bit based in that she attacked Wall Street pretty hard back in the Occupy Wall Street days.
Yeah,
was that like 20 years ago?
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
God.
Back before she got broken down.
And you know what? I would even say that it's pretty based to feign being another race in order to gain some sort of special privileges or get jobs that you normally wouldn't get. She released like a Native American cookbook or something. Or I forget what it was.
Yeah,
it is true that we like Rachel Dolezal, so I guess it's unfair to attack Elizabeth Warren.
It was her response.
But hold on, but she didn't do it convincingly. You know, like, I thought Rachel Dolezal was black, you know, like, I legitimately did. You know, like, I saw a picture, I'm like, yeah, sure, she's black. But I look at Elizabeth Warren, and you're like, the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, I don't think she really had anybody fooled, you know, and like, 164, like, whatever it was, yeah. I don't know.
Because Rachel Dolezal, like, she actually got employed by the NAACP.
Yeah, but here's the thing, is that Elizabeth Warren wouldn't have gotten caught if it wasn't for the internet. Same with Rachel Dolezal. Like, in both of these cases, these are technologies that weren't developed when she was running the scam. It's hard to fault
day-to-day interaction, right? You walk past Rachel Dolezal in her natural environment.
Walk past? I'd be crossing the street, bro.
Exactly. There you go. But with Elizabeth Warren, you walk past her, you're just like, that's some white bitch, okay? Like, you're not noticing.
I would not try and hand out any blankets to her, that's for sure.
No, exactly. There you go.
So, I don't know. I'd say for Liz Warren, maybe like halfway down cringe and maybe like a quarter virgin.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything chatter based about her, really.
No, there's not. I would even go as far as to say like an eighth virgin, because she doesn't, I don't know, she doesn't come across like that much of a virgin.
Yeah, she's definitely way more cringe than virgin, you know.
Yeah, we'll go to our last guy. You might have been wondering while watching this if you've made it this far. I noticed you haven't put anyone directly in the middle. Who could be the centrist of this? Who could take that prized title, right? And I think it's fair to say that none other than Pete Buttigieg. He can take it. Absolutely. He can take anything, so I've heard. The thing about Pete is I'm not convinced at all that he's a human in any fashion. He's never really done anything that makes me think he's based or cringe. cringe. Nothing that makes me think he's Chad or a virgin. He's a walking script. And he's not a script that does it exceptionally well. He's not a script that fails terribly. He's just so middle of the road, so forgettable. But at the same time, like, such a permanent presence of, like, who, what is this? Like, it's baffling. It's beyond.
Where did he come from?
He's so.
Where did he come from?
He's so just, like, blatantly, I don't know. There's just nothing. He's just like a middle-aged suburban man. Yeah. The only two distinguishing things about him are he was in the military and he's gay, which are kind
of
like
he came out of absolutely nowhere and left no impact or impression and, like, on anyone.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not convinced he was either in the military or he was gay. The two things that we know about him, like, I've seen nothing
are
that.
Are you telling me, dude, his husband, Chasten, is more interesting. I think there's more lore about Chasten than there is about Pete.
I wonder if
Pete ran for the presidency.
I could see Pete being like an undercover operative, you know, everything about his life.
Like, we know Chasten is a Chad because he's the top.
I mean, the first three letters of his name are C-H-A. That's a pretty Chad move.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of agree with you, Mason. I could see him being, like, some sort of intelligence operative, or...
He's so average, it's suspicious.
He blends
gets
in
my
so
ticker
perfectly.
Going, yeah.
No matter where he goes, no one will be suspicious of him. Yeah. And that, in and of itself, is so suspicious.
But for what we know of him, yeah, he's probably the center of the entire compass. He's the axis on which all the rest of this is rotating.
I'd like to congratulate Pete for taking the esteemed title of centrist of the Virgin Chad cringe-based dichotomy. I mean, what you've invented here, Mason, it's really beautiful, because the political compass as we know it is just, you know, it's too simplistic. It doesn't account for real life in a way that this one does. It's not fact-based. I mean, there's no facts and logic.
I don't know. The economic axis kind of makes sense. There's so much, like, cultural stuff that's thrown in with it that the actual political compass they use needs a third axis for culture. And this right here, this is like a pure culture compass. This is a compass that just goes into the cultural aspects of these people. And in the end of the day, like, I'm not really sure that people really care about the economic or authoritarian access. Like, do we really give a shit about their policies?
Absolutely.
This captures
not
what we want. You know, like, are they funny? Are they cool? Do we like these guys being in the Great Politics TV show or not?
Well, I think that this compass perfectly encompasses, that's right, our society. And I thank you for making it. With that, I'm going to say peace out, my grillos.
Yeah, I'm old as a boomer. My mindset on Zoomer. Everything cool as long as I'm not Laura Loomer. If you think I'm not number one, I just spell that rumor. Hit that victory boy, yeah, along some motherfucking coochie. Default dance on a bitch. Hit the default dance on a bitch. Floss dance while I'm flossing in a whip. Victory royale when that chopper hit. Self-incrimination, I have no participation. Just keep asking, I don't say shit. You can't have my conversation.